Alright, so here is an online game against an online opponent. We're just gonna watch the replay here. What happened? So at the beginning of the game, what happens is that everyone draws 7 cards and starts out with 20 life. So, drew 7 cards, 20 life, 20 life. So opponent went first, he put down a land. What you can also do at the beginning is that if you're not satisfied with your hand, you can choose to reshuffle it and draw a new hand, but you lose one card every time, so it's called a mulligan. If you do that, say you have a handful of land or you have no land, then you can choose to reshuffle it and only draw one card less each time. Alright, so it's my turn. I played my land for the turn. It's tapped, so I can't use it, and I'm done. So opponent's turn, he plays a land, end of his turn. My turn, I drew a card. Every turn you untap your land, you untap everything and you draw a card. So I put a land down and I fetch a new land, it's tapped. And I lost one life because I was a part of the land's ability. So his turn, he played a land. My turn, I drew a card, I'm gonna play a land, it's tapped. His turn. He's gonna tap, play this spell. It's a sorcery, which lets him search his deck for a card, puts it in his hand. He's done. My turn, I'm gonna play a land, and it's gonna go into play tapped, and I'm gonna play creature. This creature had one black mana and one colorless mana, so that means I tapped one land that can produce black mana, and one land that can, well, one other land that can produce any mana. And I played it. This turn, he's going to cast creature, which is a pretty powerful creature, so I think I'm going to destroy it. Great, so on my turn, what's going to happen is that I'm going to use that card's special ability to draw an extra card. Then I'm going to play this card here, which costs one black, one green, and one colorless. So tap a black mana, a green mana, and one mana of any color. And play that spell and destroy his creature, so it's dead. See, I played it. It's in my graveyard now. And I'm gonna attack with my guy. So my guy's when you attack with a creature, it becomes tapped. You can't block with it. And since he's a 2/1, he dealt 2 damage to him. And he's at 18, and he couldn't block it because he had no creatures. So his turn, he put a creature into play. Right, my turn, I drew a card, play a land, then I'm going to put a creature out. This creature lets me attack for double damage, so he's attacked for double damage. So normally he couldn't kill him, but because of this double damage thing, it's going to kill him. He's going to block, and they deal damage to each other, and he died, or he actually sacrificed it to draw a card. And it died. So he plays this spell, which it's a sorcery spell. It destroys all creatures. So my creatures died. They're in the graveyard now. It's my turn. I drew a card. It's actually a planeswalker, which requires 2 white and 2 colorless. So I tap 2 mana, 2 white mana, and 2 lands of 2 mana of any other color, and I played it. So remember that planeswalkers can be used only once per turn. So I use one of its abilities and I put a 1/1 into play. So that's my turn. And I'm going to play creature as well. This creature costs 3 mana, so I've paid 1 green, 1 white, and 1 blue to play him. So what's the opponent going to do? He's going to play a creature. It's pretty powerful. And I drew a card, a land, I'm going to play it. Then I'm going to sacrifice it and put a land into play. Then I haven't used my planeswalker yet, so I'm going to do that. But first I'm going to get a card back. So this is what I'm going to do. I'm going to do a lot of damage to him. I'm going to get my double damage guy back from the graveyard. So he's went from the graveyard to my hand. That's part of this card's ability. Come into a battlefield ability. I'm going to play it. All it. Then I'm going to use my Planeswalker to give him +3/+3 in flying. And then he's going to attack for double damage. 14 damage, actually. Alright. Since this guy had a lifelink, he dealt 14 damage to him. He's now at 4. I gained 14 life because of his ability, lifelink. It's a pretty useful ability. And he uses his ability to search for a card. And he also loses 2 life from that. So he's now only at 2. Alright, so he attacks with it. I block with my token. This is only a 1-1. He's a 5-5, so he deals 5 damage. So he's going to kill this guy. Alright, now I received some damage because of trample, which means that the damage went overflowed into me after the token died. And he's going to use the same sorcery spell to destroy all creatures. So my guys die. He's also going to use this enchantment, which can remove my Planeswalker from the game. So he's going to do that, and my Planeswalker is gone. But it's okay, because I'm going to use this spell to destroy the enchantment. So this spell lets me destroy any non-land permanent. An enchantment is a non-land permanent, so I'm going to destroy that and get my guy back. So play it. My Planeswalker is back. I produced a token as part of the Planeswalker's ability, and then played a creature. So opponent's turn. He's gonna play this creature. He's also gonna play another creature. It's my turn, I drew a card. So he's only at 2 life. I can kill him right now, but he has 1 mana tap, so he might do something with it. But to ensure that he doesn't do anything against me, I'm gonna use this card. It's 1 black mana. It lets me look at his hand and choose the card to discard from it. So it's just to make sure that he doesn't have anything. Alright, so I'm gonna give this guy +3/+3 flying because I discarded this card. And I'm gonna attack him. And he died, so it's a conceit. And that's the end of the game. Second part of the video, I'm going to show you how to play Magic. This is an actual game. I'm playing with someone online. And it'll teach you the basics of how it works. Alright, so here you can see my land. My hand, I mean. So that's my hand. Mulligan means you can reshuffle it at the cost of 1 less card, a shuffle. So you can draw a new hand, but you have 1 less card. So the opponent went, so now it's my turn. So it's my turn now. So every turn you can play 1 land, right? So I play this land. It comes into play tapped, so it can't be used. Remember that cards that are tapped are already used and can't be used anymore. Okay, so his turn is done. Puts that into play. Okay, so it's my turn again. So I draw a new card. Put down another land and play this creature. It has 1 black and 1 colorless mana cost, so I can tap this for black and tap this for any color, it doesn't matter. And he goes on the field. The opponent can choose to respond to it or let it go on the battlefield. Okay. Opponent's turn. Okay, so he plays a creature. Okay, my turn. This ability activates. So I use the ability. He draws me an extra card. Then I play it. I pay 1 life to use this card, so notice how everyone starts at 20 life. I pay 1 life, sacrifice it, goes in my graveyard, then I choose one of my land cards. This one I can choose to pay 2 life to make it come to play untapped, which I will do. So now I can cast to another creature, just this one, which requires 2 green and 1 colorless. So here we go, green, green, something else. And he goes up. And I'm going to attack with this guy. So he's attacking. Okay, so now he's tapped to show that he's attacking. The opponent can choose to block it, or you can choose to take damage. So he chose to take the damage, now he's at 18 life. Goes into play. Remember that artifacts can stay on the battlefield. He attacks with his guy, so I can choose to block it, and which I will do. I'll block it, so they both do damage to each other. Okay, so they both die. Alright. So I play my land. Then I play this creature, which requires three different colors of mana. So I need a green, then I need a white, and I need a blue. Right. So got him out. Of course I can't attack with him since I just cast them, so I will attack with this guy. Okay, he took the damage, because he has no blockers. So, this guy's 1 mana, cast him, play green. And cast this guy as well. 2 green and 1 colorless. There's my 1 colorless, green, and green. Okay, so can't do anything with those guys yet. Just cast them, so I can attack with these two guys. Right. And he's probably going to take damage since he has no blockers. He's still thinking. Okay, my turn. Right, get my cards, put it down on land. No, I can put a guy out. So he's. This guy is 2 mana, 1 colorless. Put him out. Alright. And gonna attack with these guys. And that guy draws me a card, which is part of his ability. Now I'll choose to use it. Okay. Puts a land out. So he's only got 3 life. I don't know what he's gonna do there. This better be something that can save his ass. No, it's that guy. Okay, whatever. We can deal with him. In fact, I can deal with him right now because I have an instant in my hand. It's one mana, one white mana instant, which can remove him from remove this creature from the game. All I need is one white mana, which I have, and I'm gonna remove him from the game. I'm gonna kill him this turn. As you can see, he's only at 3 life. Okay, so I can just show you a Planeswalker, even though I don't need to cast him, but I'll cast this guy. Planeswalker, 4 mana. So it's 2 white, 2 of any other color. Cast it. Then I use one of its abilities. So put a 1/1 token into play. Token is just a creature that has no physical form. Alright, but it's still a creature. And all I need to do is attack for 3. So this guy's a 3/4, he does 3 damage, I'll attack with him. And I think that's enough to kill him. And the game's over. Good game. Here's another game to show you the basics of Magic. So, would you like to mulligan to 6 cards? No, I think we're fine. You will mulligan if you don't have enough lands or you have too much land. Okay, so that's his turn. He's done. Puts down a land. Remember that every turn you can play 1 land. Okay, so we're going to put down this land. Comes to play tapped. That's it. Okay, so he casts an artifact creature, which is both an artifact and a creature. I'll put this land. Do play. It's tapped, so I can't use it. I'll use this card. It lets me see his hand and discard a card. 1 black mana is all I need. Okay, so here's his hand. I'll discard this card. Okay, and I lose 2 life as a part of this spell's ability. It's part of its cost, actually. Okay, so he puts an equipment into play, which you can use to put on his creature. Puts another creature out. And he's attacking with that creature. It's tapped. I don't have any blockers, so I had to take the damage. So I took 2 damage because it was a 2/2. So my turn. I put out a card. I'm going to put out a blocker here. I don't have any green mana and I wanted to cast that guy, but I can't. I only have black mana, so I cast this guy. His turn. Okay, so he equips that guy. That guy's now a 7-2, meaning that he does 7 damage to my creature or me. Blocking, I think I will block the 7-2, so I don't take 7 damage. My guy will die, but at least I don't take 7 damage. I take 2 damage from that guy who wasn't blocked. Okay, so he casts an instant spell. Says I can't cast a spell this turn, which is kind of annoying. So can't do anything. End of my turn. Alright, puts another guy out. Equips that guy. And I'm going to be taking 7 damage. Right, so I'm at 7. I'm going to put this land into play. I'm going to put this guy into play. See, this guy can actually be cast for a variety of different costs. You can choose one. It's a hybrid. So I choose to cast it for green, white, and one colorless. And when it comes into play, I gain 2 life. Okay. So now I'm at 9, because I gained 2 life from this guy. Right, so it looks like he put it on his flying guy instead. So he equipped it on to his flying guy, and he's going to attack with his flying guy, which I can't block. Remember that flying can only be blocked by flying, and my guy doesn't have flying. I will block the guy that doesn't have flying. And as a part of an ability, my guy comes back. It's just an ability my guy has. He can come back. Okay. So then on my turn, I play this card. 1 mana, put it out, Birds of Paradise. Then I'll cast the sorcery spell on this card here. So this one can destroy any non-land permanent. So it costs black, green, and one colorless. So here's black, green, one colorless, which I will use to destroy that stupid equipment. Okay. And I'm done. Puts another equipment out. So what this equipment does is the equipped creature has haste and shroud. So it means haste means they can attack the turn it comes out. Shroud means I can't target him with anything. So what can I do here? Okay, I'm gonna play my planeswalker. 2 white, 2 colorless. Wait, play it. I'm gonna use one of its abilities. Target creature gets +3/+3 in flying, so he gets +3 power and toughness, and flying as well, and I'll attack him with it. He can choose to block or not. So in this instance, he chose not to block and take the damage. So he took 5 damage. Okay, not doing anything that turn. My turn. Play a land. Can't use it, though, it's tapped. I'm going to save these cards because he can counter one of his spells in case he has one. And I'll do the same thing. Give him plus three, and attack. And looks like he conceded the game. Okay, so another game. Would I like to play first? Yes, I would. Then would I like to mulligan? Which means if I want a new hand, with one less card in it. No, I don't. Okay, so I go first, I'll put this land down into play. It's tapped, I can't use it. End of my turn. Okay, so he's using this sorcery spell to give him some library or card advantage. So each color has its strengths and weaknesses. Blue is good at library manipulation, counter spells, controlling creatures, stuff like that. Green is good at creatures, so green generally has the biggest creatures. He suspends a card, which means it's not going to come into play until a couple turns later. So green has the biggest creatures. Red has lots of burn spells, direct damage spells, and haste spells. I'm going to play this one for green. Black has lots of draining life spells and spells that kill creatures. And lastly, white has a lot of spells that has defense, gaining life, and pretty efficient creatures as well. But yeah, every spell has its own kind of specialty. So he uses a spell again. I have a feeling he's playing a combo deck. Why else would he have two Lotus Blossoms? Interesting. Okay, my turn, play land. Yeah, one of this creature's abilities is that it can tap for mana, so I actually now have 3 mana. And I'll play this guy. So he needs green, white, and blue. So we'll tap for green, tap for white, and thanks to this creature, it can produce mana of any color, so tap for blue, and it comes into play. There it is. Can't do anything else, all my permanents are tapped. So he removes a counter from his cards. Once those counters are removed, it comes into play. It's just a part of that card's ability, suspend. Alright, looks like he's not going to do anything. My turn. So I have 2 counter spells right now. I can choose to not tap my mana, not cast anything, and wait for him to cast a spell which I can counter. Or I can cast something like this guy and do tons of damage to him. So it's a hard choice. What is he doing? So maybe I'll cast this guy, see what he responds with. So this guy needs 4 mana. Bunch of colored mana too. So he's probably going to counter it. He's responding. So yep, he counters it. It gets returned to my hand. And I'll attack with this guy. Attack. Now he's tapped. And he does damage. Right. So I have a feeling he's going to do something this turn. Both of his Lotus Blossoms are now into play, which means I should have kept my counterspell. Let's see what it does. So that's interesting, he didn't do anything. Maybe he's waiting for something. Okay, so I play my land. I don't want to pay 2 life. This time I'll save the counterspell. I mean, he probably has some counterspells or something. I'm gonna attack with this guy. Right. So part of this guy's abilities is that he has lifelink, which means I gain whatever damage he dealt, so that's why I'm at 26, because I gained life, and he's at 14. Because I did a total of 6 damage with this guy, so I gained 6 life, he lost 6 life. So he still didn't do anything. My turn. Maybe still wait for him to do something. In the meantime, I can keep on attacking him. Okay, so gained some more life. He took some more damage. Looks like he still has nothing. So let's take a look at what's in his hand. I'll play this card. Only requires 1 black. And he conceded. There's probably a combo deck. Okay, so this is an actual live game. Me against an online opponent. So would I like to play first? Sure. Okay, just to show you what Magic is about. So here's my hand, I draw 7 cards. I start out with 20 life, but I like to mulligan. What mulligan means is that you can have a reshuffle at the cost of 1 less card. So I would only do that if I have too many or not enough lands. Okay, so first turn, I can play 1 land a turn, remember? So I play this land. So this is a special land that I pay 1 life. So I lose 1 life, and I can search another land to put into play. So I'll search for this one. Don't want to pay 2 life. Comes in play tapped, so I can't use it. Okay, so opponent's turn, he plays a land. And he casts this spell for 0. Okay, he also plays another artifact, which stays on the battlefield. So this is an artifact creature. It's an artifact and a creature. Okay, so second turn, I draw a card. Right, and every turn you draw a card. And I play my land for the turn. Do I want to play 2 life? No, I don't. It's tapped. So then I play this card, which is 1 green mana cost. All I had to do is tap this for 1 green mana. And there it goes. Okay, so he puts this creature out. He also casts this creature. So he casts a sorcery spell, This one says draw two cards, so he's going to draw two cards. Puts another artifact into play. Okay, end of his turn. It's my turn again. So, part of this creature's ability is that it can add mana to my mana pool, so it helps me. So what I'm going to do is put this planeswalker out. It's going to need two blue and one colorless. So there's one blue. This guy adds another blue. And one mana of any color, which is colorless mana. Right, so this planeswalker gets played. Okay, so I use one of its abilities. So each player draws a card. Alright, and that's it. Since you can only use planeswalkers once per turn. And notice I added two counters to him, so now he's at 5. He has 5 life now. Okay, he plays another one of these. He's using one of his artifact's abilities to add mana. And he plays this card. Alright, I don't like that card, so I'm going to use this sorcery spell next turn to kill it. Okay, so he's going to attack with his creatures, possibly against me or my planeswalker. Okay, so he chooses to attack me. So remember, they're tapped when they attack. I can't block since my creature's tapped, so I have to take damage. Right, so now I'm at 16 because I took 3 damage since he was a 2-2, but 1-1. They did 3 damage. Okay, so what I can choose to do this turn, actually, use my planeswalker to draw me a card. Right, so I'm going to play my land since I now drew a land. Alright, so put this into play. Now I can pay 2 life. Okay, so I'm going to use this card. It's an instant, which means I could have used it on the opponent's turn, but I didn't have mana. So I only need to pay 1 white for this, so I'm going to do that. I'm going to remove it from the game. So he's dead, he's removed. Removed from the game is different than being in the graveyard. It means the opponent cannot use him in the graveyard anymore. Because once something goes in the graveyard, there might be cards that actually use it. Okay, so now I'm gonna play something else. This card is 1 green, 1 colorless. I'm gonna play this guy. See what the opponent does on his turn. Yep, he gets another one of these guys out. Is he gonna attack? If he attacks, I can block with my 3-4. So he attacks with that guy. It's only a 1-1, so I can kill him by blocking it. So we'll do that. Right, so I can cast, get my land. I'm not going to play 2 life. I'm going to use my Planeswalker to draw me a card. Okay, good. So what I'm going to do this turn is I'm going to cast an equipment. So it's an artifact. I can use any mana to cast it. So I'm going to equip my guy with it. Remember, my guy couldn't attack last turn because creatures can attack the turn they're cast. They had to wait a turn unless they have haste. So I'm going to attack with this guy. Okay, so he's tapped to show that he's attacking. The opponent can choose to block it, or they can choose to take damage. Let's give them some time to think. Right, so he conceded. Because he knew he was going to lose. Alright, so this is an online Magic the Gathering match against an online opponent. So, first thing when everyone starts the game, everyone draws 7 cards each, and we both start out with 20 life. So 7 cards, 20 life as you can see. And the opponent went first, so you put out a land. Next is my turn, I put down a land, it's tapped, so I can't use it. So then it's the opponent's turn, he puts down his land at the end of my turn. And then it's his turn, he puts down his land. So it's my turn, I put down my land for the turn. Remember that only one land can be played per turn. And I put out this creature. 1 green mana, so I tapped 1 green mana for that. So he puts down a land. So I draw my card. At the beginning of every turn, you untap all your lands and you draw a card. So I do nothing. Next his turn, he puts a creature out, and then use that creature's ability. I decided to put this creature out. It's a 2 green mana, 1 colorless mana. So I tap 2 for green mana and 1 for another mana, doesn't matter. He just puts down a land, that's it. So I put down my land and attack my creature. He uses an instant. Remember, instants can be used during other people's turns. So I will use my counterspell. The counterspell is just to make this card have no effect. And what he does is he uses another one. So this card is removed from the game because his card, he played 2 of them, so 1 of them went through. So now it's his turn. Plays a creature. So my turn, I'm going to destroy that creature using this card. It's a sorcery. So it destroys any non-land permanent. But he uses another spell before I do that to kill my card, so my guy's dead. But at least he died. I destroyed him as well. So I play a creature. And part of that creature's ability, I gain 2 life. I'm at 21. He's at 25 because his card gains him life at the end of every turn. He attacks. I can't block it because it's flying. I take 1 damage. It's my turn. I draw a card. I play him. 1 green, 1 colorless. He's 2 black, 1 colorless. I play him as well. Opponent's turn. He plays this card against it. Basically, it deals X damage against it, so I guess he's dead. He's in the graveyard now. And then he gains life at the end of every turn. Thanks to that card. And I play another card. Same one, actually. I have 2 of them. And then he plays his creature, which also gains him life. And I put down a land for the turn. Then I attack. So, good thing about this creature is that it has a lot of abilities, and it gains me life as well. So, this ability is actually called Lifelink, and whenever he deals damage, I gain that much life. Okay, so it's my turn. I put down another land, attack with him again. Let's see his turn. He puts down another creature and gains life. So I'm going to put an equipment into play. This is a very powerful equipment. It can do many things. So I'm going to equip it. Remember, you pay the equip cost to equip a creature with it. And I'm going to attack with it. This equipment can do many things. It can kill creatures. So I kill that guy. I use that equipment's ability. You can do several things. He uses a sorcery to draw some cards. He also loses life, but he's still at 32. And he uses this creature's ability and attacks. And I didn't block. So I'm only at 19. So my turn, I draw a card. I play this guy. 2 green, 1 colorless. I attack with him again. Then I use, I get some counters on this. He casts an enchantment, actually. But this enchantment does, whenever he gains life, I lose that much health. So it's a really annoying enchantment. Then he puts the creature out. Alright, and what happened to that creature is that it was only a 2-1, so I use this artifact's ability, because I counters on it, to kill it. So the equipment's very useful. Unfortunately, I also lost life because of his enchantments. Effect. So what I'm going to do is, I don't like this card. It gains him too much life, so I'm going to remove it using this card. It's only 1 white mana. It's an instant. It means it can be played on both mine and my opponent's turns. Then attack and get some more counters. My equipment. This turn, he puts down a creature. An angel, actually. And he's going to attack, and it's going to gain him life, which also I'm going to block. So when he attacks, notice his creature taps, means it's attacking. So when I block, I can block with more than one creature, so that he deals combined damage to him. Remember, you can only block with creatures that's not tapped, so I can't block with this guy, but I can block with this guy. He uses an ability to make him get +3/+3. I was expecting him to use that ability, that's why I blocked him with 2 creatures. But as a result, both of them die. Good thing this guy has regeneration, so I regenerated him and he doesn't die. And this creature is part of his ability, he comes back into play. And I also lost more life because of this enchant. So it's my turn, my ability. I use this powerful sorcery spell that can do 2 things. First of all, I can kill this guy, and I'm going to bring a guy back from my graveyard. So I do that, he's back, that guy's dead, and I attack with everyone. So I'm going to kill this guy with my equipment. His turn, he plays another one of those angels. And he's going to attack. I blocked with my my vampire, and since that death touch, it means that death touch is an ability, means it can destroy any creature it blocks and does damage to. So he died. So my turn. I play this guy. I'm going to attack. He takes all the damage. He doesn't block. So then I'm only at 24. So he does on his turn. He plays another creature. And first of all, I'm gonna use my equipment and then kill this guy first. I don't want to do any more damage. So my equipment's gonna kill it. That guy comes into play. My turn. I use his ability, draw an extra card. Let me use my equipment ability. Attack with him. Get some more counters on that. Use the sorcery, draw more cards. Then he tries to get rid of my creature, but I counterspell it using this card, which counterspells it. And what all I also did with this card was I brought that other creature back to his hand, so it's no longer on the battlefield. Okay, so my card, I draw an extra card, and then this is a planeswalker. Remember that planeswalkers can only be, its abilities can only be used once a turn, so I use it to untap my lands. And then I look at his hand, see what he has, discard it, attack with all my creatures. And what's he gonna do? He's gonna use this card, an instant card. He can use it during my turn. It didn't do him much good though because he's still at 12. Did a lot of damage to him. Then he puts a creature out, kills one of my creatures. He also gets a 1/1 token. Not bad, but I think I'm gonna kill him. So what I'm gonna do is, this is my kill turn. What I did was I sacrificed my Crane Planeswalker basically to give everyone +3/+3, and so they all have +3/+3 trample. I'm gonna attack with everyone, and it's gonna do a lot of damage to him. So he's dead, and I won the turn. And that's basic Magic: The Gathering game.